Hey everybody, this is Linda. Thanks for tuning in. So I want to show you how to use the Stamparatus to do four-step stamping. So in the occasions catalog, there is a great stamp set called Amazing Congratulations. It has three parts to it and lots of little greetings that go with it. And it sort of has a watercolor look to it, like almost like a brush stroke. So when you stamp these all together, you get a card like that. So this is a card that I showed at the onstage event for Stampin' Up! In November. And I've had the Stamparatus and been able to play with it all this time, and I love it. It's really a great, great tool. So let me show you how to use it to incorporate both sides. So you've got four stamping sides. First thing I'm gonna do, I like to start with my outline first for the congratulations. You can do them in any order. I like the outline first. It gives me something to go on. We're gonna mount that to the plate and put my magnets on so that stays where it's supposed to stay. All right, now from here, I like to pick this up, and I've got all these great little grid lines. Can you see those? So I just wanna look at it and make sure that it looks nice and straight. I'm gonna ink it in Early Espresso and give it a little press across. There's my outline. Now, I could clean this up if I want to, but I'm just gonna, let's say I wanna stamp a whole bunch of them, I'm just gonna leave that, turn this around, and now we can do the second step. This is the next outline, or the next little color we're gonna do in Lemon Lime Twist. And because it's photopolymer, I can look right through there and see that that's gonna line up. Press that in, so I'm mounting it, and then I can ink it with the green. So this is my next little piece. And what's nice is if I don't get it all the way, I can go back and add more color if I want to and do it again because it's not moving. So I can get it as dark as I want it. Now, step number three is the final piece of this congratulations stamp. And this is gonna be in Pool Party. I'm gonna line this up. I kind of look for the dots of the I and the G and the tails and get those lined up. And I'm gonna come in from the top. And we're gonna ink this up in the Pool Party. Be careful when you're inking that you don't get a lot of ink on the hinges. It's not gonna go on your paper, but I find I'll hit my finger with it and that, you know, so just be careful that you don't get it everywhere. Okay, and there is my three steps. Now, one more step, I'm gonna turn this around and let's do a greeting. So what's really cool is that I could have this set up at a class or something and have all these ready to go and just teach everybody how to turn it to stamp all their pieces. So they'll get nice, easy placement. Now, for the little greetings, I wanna make sure that's really good where it is. So I'm gonna take, this is my imaging sheet for my Stamp-A-Majig, but anything clear and plastic that you can see through and wipe off. If you put that on top of this, just like that, and then when you ink it, then you can really be sure, because you've come this far, you really don't wanna mess it up. So see, that looks pretty good. But if I didn't like it, I can wipe this off and then move this around and try it again. But for me, that's pretty good. So now I can ink that up for the final. And it's really awesome. So what I did on this card is I mounted it this way and trimmed off the extra. And this is on foil frenzy paper, foil paper. And I also did it on this new paper that's coming out in the occasions catalog January 3rd called Sweet Soiree. Really pretty with all the silver. And then I did the different colors of pinks in there. All right, that's it for me. We'll see you next time. See it, learn it, stamp it.